Well, howdy, 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 folks. I know that we are going live at 8 p.m. tonight, and we're going to be discussing the, well, we've got a lot of questions. It's show like 173 or something tonight on Facebook. It's the normal live Q&A on Thursday nights at 8. That's 8 p.m. Eastern. Love to have you here if you've got time. But, hey, Michael Wood with Doug's Dogs, good, is in the house. And, I have, I got a question today on YouTube that was interesting. YouTube has gotten busier and busier lately, and so I get quite a few questions daily on there, but I want to read you this one and see what you think, okay? Because it's one of those deals where, well, you'll see, okay? I'm going to just read it to you. As part of my due diligence, this is from 88 Seagrave. As part of my due diligence, I went down to my local borough hall and got the paperwork I need to start the process to get the prime spot in town by the public boat ramp and waterfront area. I was shocked to hear that it will cost $3,000 up front, not up back, up front. Okay. And that's only for a time period of from May to late October. Okay. New Jersey weather. That turns out to be approximately $500 per month, $125 a week, or $4 a day. That helps with the sting a little bit when you break it down to $4 a day, but the $3,000 is a tough nut to crack, and I'm not sure how great the spot is as far as how it's the number of dogs sold. By the way, as I read what I wrote back to myself, I find I start talking like you. Ben, I love it. So you start talking like a hillbilly. I got you. With poor grammar. So let me answer this because this is a good question. $3,000 is a tough nut to crack. It's an investment up front. It's a bam. Hope this works. Okay. Now there's some things you can do to make sure that you've done your due diligence before you even take on such a commitment or such a investment, because whether we don't know whether it's a good investment yet or not, or a bad investment. So we want to narrow that down with due diligence. And the due diligence we want to do first is we want to find out from the town or the city, whoever is managing that spot and charging that fee, we want to find out how they came up with that fee. Well, guess what? Because of the Freedom of Information Act, you're privy to any meetings that they have, meeting notes that show how they came up with that fee. My guess is they came up with the fee based on previous people they test marketed there. Now, where did those people go and why aren't they there now, right? And is it an exclusive spot or is it one that they'll sell nine times and now you're splitting the potential profits with nine people? So you need to know these things before you take on a commitment such as this, $3,000. Now, when you break it down and you go $4 a day, that's nothing. Well, you ain't going to be vending for every day, right? Okay, you shouldn't be. You shouldn't be vending every day. You should have a location that allows you to vend two to three times a week, and then the rest of the week is you time, fishing time. Maybe you call me up and say, let's go fishing. I'll go fishing with you. So you shouldn't be breaking it down all the way down to the day, because the day is kind of, it's kind of a false sense of the value. So I would break it down to the week, and then I'd go, okay, I'm probably going to be there 3 days a week. Now, if you're going to be there 7 days a week, but you're going to have another employee there, you're still going to have bad weather days. My car broke down. My neighbor's chicken's having puppies and I couldn't go. Uncle Tom, I'm sorry, Bob, I couldn't make it, whatever it is, right? It just depends on, you know, for a fact, you will not be there 7 days a week. It's impossible. So break it down maybe to five, okay? Well, at five, you're probably like $650. It's $143 a week or whatever it was. I think it was $148 a week. $125 a week. $125 a week. Doesn't sound bad. Break that into 3 days. Okay. Still not bad as long as it's a good location. So I already gave you some of the things you need to find out first, and you have the right as an American citizen to get access to that information. Find out also, is the price negotiable? Is there a test market time? Petition the city or the town to give you a test market. Say, listen, we want to try it. We want to try it for 2 months or 2 weeks or 2 days or whatever it is, right? They should be able and willing to do that. And then you don't have an upfront commitment as large because now you can test market it. I'd want to test market that location first. I typically tell vendors to steer clear of these types of things in the beginning, because it's not that the $125 a week's bad. It's that they're wanting $3,000 up front. That's bad to me. That's a lot of money for you to put out with very little information on its effectiveness. So you don't know if you're going to be successful there yet. You don't know what's going to happen there yet. So I'm helping a lady. Well, I say I'm helping. I'm done helping her. It worked. But I helped her this summer. She did a similar situation. She got a location like this where she paid a lot of money for. Guess what? It just didn't work. It didn't work. Guess what we did instead? She was already committed. She had already paid this exorbitant fee for 2 months. I think it was 45 days. She had paid this big fee for 45 days. I said, listen, here's what I want you to do. And I showed her where to buy some promotional items, t-shirts and stuff, and then told her to hire her. She has a sister-in-law that needed work. She hired her sister-in-law that went out there and set up a little card table and sold freaking novelty items. She made her money back with novelty items. Not the ideal situation. You didn't get into this to sell novelty items, right? So that's what I want to share with you, is that it's one of those deals where you want to limit your risk. You want to go in knowing as much information as possible, and you can get that information through the city, town, state, whoever manages that spot, whoever you're going to be paying this $3,000 to. Okay. I don't ever suggest paying that for a new vendor, because you typically, a new vendor doesn't have just a wealth of money just sitting around. I wonder what I'm going to do with this $3,000. I guess I'll just, blow it. No, you want to do it smart. You want to get out. The goal when you get in business is to get from the red, which is when you're in the negative, to the positive, the black, as quickly as possible. Well, what's the quickest way there? Making wise decisions, not taking on huge events where there's a lot of risk. You want to find good locations, go out and get those locations. I teach you that stuff for free at learnhotdogs.com. It's literally that simple. Okay. So that avoids the risk. I think that's it. I'm going to cover one other question real quick. Okay. And I promised this guy I would. I don't think it's in the show notes for tonight. But just to remind you, 8 p.m. tonight, we'll be doing the live Q&A show. Join us here, right here on Facebook, and I'll be doing it. But here's the question I got, was about, let me pull this up real quick. This is from Jeff. He says his town is requiring him to have access to bathrooms. I don't know if he means the customers have access to a bathroom, or does he mean that he has access to a bathroom? Now, as a mobile vendor, bottom line is no town can say legally can say, oh, you're a vendor, you have to have a bathroom within 200 feet. Now, are there some towns that do that? Yes, there are. The ones that have been challenged, though, have found out real quickly they violated your constitutional rights. There's nothing that they create these rules in order to restrict or funnel the potential for big business to have competition. Ooh, boogie, 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 man, scary. Okay. They don't want it. Well, guess who came up with these asinine rules? Restaurant owners. Big deep pocket restaurant owners petitioned the city, or they got on the city council, or they got on the zoning commission, and they said, let's make some rules because we don't want the unsavory hot dog vendor out here. And so some of them are smart enough to look and go, oh, we can't make a move every 15 minutes, or we can't make a move every 45 minutes, and we can't do this because that would violate the law. So let me see. We'll make them put a bathroom and a pink mosquito net. and their tires have to be red and have to have four corners. Stupid shit, right? Just complete stupidity. And this is what unfettered capitalism does. It's crony capitalism. It's where we let the wealthiest, richest, most powerful people control the rules. But the nice part is our founding fathers and the smart people from way back when, they created our constitutional rights, the Bill of Rights. They created rules that prevent this. Now, it doesn't stop some city from challenging it, but they never win. Okay. Once they're challenged, we're so sorry, Mr. Johnson. We didn't realize you were, we're sorry about that. You don't need a pink mosquito net. Okay. So it's just a scam. The bottom line is the bathroom deal. I had a vendor in Washington State. Okay. Who, his town told him he had to have a bathroom within 200 feet. Well, he's a mobile vendor. He's like got three different locations. That means he's got to go to a restaurant, a competitor, and say, hey, can my customers use your bathroom, please? I need a letter signed. Now, California has a couple counties that do this too. And then it's all illegal. Okay. It's illegal and it violates constitutional law. I'm not going to go into that again. The point is that he went and got a porta potty. Well, the town got upset because he's pulling with his truck a porta potty. And guess what they did? They said, oh, we're taking away that bathroom rule. You don't have to have a bathroom anymore. Because they didn't like it, because it was an eyesore. Here's this porta potty going to different locations. They said, nope. And we had this guy on the radio show. It's been several years ago at Hot Dog Vendor Radio, which is now the live Facebook show. Okay. So always challenge what they say. Ask to see it in writing first. That's your first step. Always ask to see it in writing because you may be getting someone's interpretation or somebody's BS or somebody just pulled it out of their ass. The rule, right? It doesn't even exist. 9 times out of 10, the rule you'll hear, if it's stupid, doesn't even exist. So when you ask for it, they go, oh, well, we can't find it. We don't have a rule. We looked everywhere. I think it's locked in the filing cabinet in Betsy's, and Betsy retired last year. So either way, it's all BS. The bottom line is once you do, if you can get the rule, then you find out, you're interpreting this wrong. It says right here that I have to have running water, but it has nothing saying about a bathroom. So I do have running water on my cart. And you're saying that means bathroom? And then you just call the state. And the state will tell you, okay, who told you? Oh, Tom told you that in King County? Well, Tom's a moron. We'll let Tom know to leave you alone. I kid you not. This is how this works. These are human beings who don't want to deal with it, who are lazy-minded many times, or let their ego, they like the power trip of being able to say, no, you got to have a pink mosquito net. Susan, you're going to have to pink mosquito net. That's our code. Well, let me see the code. Well, it doesn't say that exactly. What it says is that you have to have an umbrella. Yeah, but that doesn't say mosquito net. This, I'm not kidding you. I am not kidding you. This happened in Atlanta, Georgia. Okay. We had a health inspector tell someone they needed a mosquito net. Turned out the code just said a covering over top of the cart. An umbrella, they actually listed as an example of an approved covering. But yet, this inspector, Captain Moron, said, you need a mosquito net. Needs to come all the way to the ground. And if you move, the mosquito net has to move with you. Are you freaking kidding me? We have had a blast with some of these because some of them are just, I just gave you some of the worst ones, but because it's funny, you know, it's funny. I hope you enjoyed this and I'll talk to you later. We'll be back at 8 tonight, live here, Q&A. If you got questions, go ahead and submit them now or post them in the comments on the show tonight, and I'll try my best to get to him. Jason will be joining me from Love Food Truck Company, and I'm excited. It's going to be a good one tonight.